just to say you know, I hope you have tried out to get one over which way you went with the motel across the country of the house. This car was a two-seater, which was fitted with a double canopy for ease of access. It is thought that about 30 of these cars still survive in the world today.
So I wonder how much of there I've got.
Yeah, no, I can put the pictures in a bit, yes. That'd be nice.
Ice cream loving cat. is a retired bricklayer from Denton, Texas. This 80-year-old Southern gentleman's fascination for barbed wire will blow your mind.
We really going in the garage.
But over the last 4 years, has taken on gigantic proportions.
Limpy.
Today, the Texan is proud of this. The largest barbed wire balloon ever made by man. It weighs nearly 12 tons, and if unraveled, it will stretch over 600 miles. The ball is created using a rhino horn and a homemade screw. JC and his son Joey actually wrap the wire by circling the ball again and again and again.
What the hell?
Right.
Hmm? I bought that one at home.
Yeah. Installed, that is, installed. Well, that you're home to see for yourself. Ah, as they say, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, and arms up. Woo! Come
on, Edna, that's one of them things.
Taking the view.
It's hot on the old ash there. I think it's time to wet me whistle. Oh. Strictly medicinal, you understand? I'm not really sure what the medicinal value it has these days, given the fact that I happen to be dead. So while here, let me tell you about good old Robert Ripley's fascination with the dearly departed. Yes. There's many an interesting epitaph to be found chiseled here in granite from around the world.
Welcome to Psychic Sarah. Do you want to know the future?
Looking again. Oh yeah, because I'm looking this way. Yeah, big fight. Thank you. If you look through there, you can see like a naked woman.
The strange and the incredible have been highlighted at exhibits just like the one you're in since the early 1930s. They were first referred to as believe it or not auditoriums and have been present since his first auditorium at the Chicago World's Fair in 1933. At that time, over 2.5 million people paid over $1 million to see Ripley's collection of oddities and curiosities. One of the many reasons for the popularity of Ripley's collections, which has sustained over these many years, is his focus on unusual people, not just in faraway places, but right here at home.
Let me introduce my happy family. This is my wife, Carol Jr., 16 months old. Eugene, 11 years. Helen, 13. Betty, 9. And this is Robin. Robert is 7 feet 10 inches tall, weighs 360 pounds, and 16 years old.
In 1939, at the age of 21, he was more than 8 feet 8 inches tall and weighed 491 pounds. Quiet, shy, sensitive to his size.
Thank you. Safe distance away from his enemies and begin the steps necessary to shrink the head. First, the Jabaro slit the scalp from the crown of the head to the nape of the neck. Then, with great care, he will peel away the skin of the face and the scalp from the skull. The skull is then torn away, preferably into a river, and the skin is stretched over a spear and thrust into a vessel of hot water. It is in this vessel where the shrinking process begins.
Take a picture with your phone. So your dad will get back.
Yeah, that's
fine. Go on, take a picture with your phone. Wait, come back a bit. Right, go on. Walk through.
Oh, I see what it's doing.
Get it in and stop.
Yeah.